Did your glow up bring out the haters? Or maybe you've been hesitant to improve yourself and go through a transformation for that very reason. If your transformation is making other people around you feel uncomfortable, this video is for you. All right, so we have the new year coming up, and new year, new you is gonna be right around the corner. Now, if you are trying to improve yourself, better your life, lose weight, gain more confidence, have a better anything, you're gonna wanna watch this video. Embarking on a journey to improve yourself is one of the most empowering things you can do, especially for us women. But the truth is that not everybody is ready for our transformation. So let's dive into how to navigate our transformation glow up journey with confidence and grace and love so that you can continue to be in your power and shine. I'm just gonna come out and say it because it is the truth. It's what I've experienced and what I've seen a lot of other women experience. But when you do decide to improve yourself, whether that is internally, externally, or both, you will probably lose at least one person in your life, and it might even shock you who that person is. Because what's gonna happen is your transformation is going to make other people uncomfortable. It's going to expose their own areas where they are settling and stifling and not showing up as who they want to show up as. It might leave them feeling a little triggered and maybe even a little threatened by how happy you now are, or how confident you now are, or how successful you now are. But honestly, that is no reason to be a bitch to them or to stop yourself from reaching your full potential and shining as bright as you know you can shine. And so I personally believe when you go through a transformation and you have bettered yourself, or you are wanting to better yourself, you're gonna be essentially showing up differently. You're going to be acting differently, behaving differently, dressing differently, speaking differently. You're gonna be tolerating less. You're going to have boundaries. You know, you're not gonna be maybe doing the same things that you have been doing, and you're going to swap them out for healthier things. You're going to be filling your time with things that actually bring you purpose and fulfillment and connection, and not all of these dry things with drama that involves drinking and other D things. And so I believe when you do transform yourself, allow others around you to adjust and adapt to the new you, because they have been used to how you have been, and it will be kind of like a shock to them because they're gonna be like, well, you've changed, and you're gonna be like, well, duh, I've changed. Like, isn't that a good thing? But we don't want to lose people from our lives. We don't want to push people away because we've bettered ourselves. So like my approach when I am trying to improve myself is I hope to inspire others around me to do the same. I want to inspire others to step out of their comfort zones, shine a little brighter, maybe dress how they really wanting to dress, speak how they really want to speak, show up in their life how they really want to show up, and be very authentic and real with who they are. So if you are receiving hate from people who really don't mean anything to you, just let it slide. Try not to hang around those people, maybe set some boundaries, you know, don't even bother with them. But if you are receiving maybe some hurtful remarks and some snarky little things from people you truly love, and it could even be like your husband, then that's the time to really put your foot down, stay in your core self, stay compassionate, stay caring, stay kind, stay confident, and allow other people to adjust around you. And trust that who's meant to stay in your life will absolutely do everything in their power to stay in their life, in your life, and root you on. And the people who were really just comfortable with you being comfortable and not shining your light so bright, they're gonna eventually be a little threatened, be a little triggered, and they probably will naturally fall off. And that is a good thing. And I just want to kind of stop here and say that as I'm recording this video, I just got done doing 3.5 hours of math with my son. I homeschool him. He's in 8th grade. We're doing pre-algebra. So like, if I stumble over my words, please give me some grace. You know, there is nothing more that I want for my friends and for those who are in my community than to truly see what they are capable of becoming and doing in their life. I think that just for us to be here and to be living and to have this free will to do, be, have whatever we want in this life is so amazing, and it's something that we shouldn't take for granted. So if in any area of your life you are feeling like you're really not doing as good as you could be doing, you're not expressing yourself as much as you want to express yourself, you're not speaking in a way that empowers you and puts your foot down, then maybe this is the sign and the opportunity to explore that and see which areas of your life that you could start improving. And if you're somebody like me, when somebody doubts me or tells me that I can't do something, that is just fuel on the fire, and it is one of my biggest motivators to almost all the success that I've had in different areas of my life. So if you do have people around you who are putting you down, doubting you, judging you, expressing their opinions, trying to pull you back to that person that you are trying not to be anymore, use that as fuel and double down on those goals and on those dreams. You know, now would be a great time to take inventory of your life. Take inventory specifically of your health, of your mental health, of your friends, your environment, your relationships, what you're doing with your free time, and how you're speaking to yourself. And explore those areas and see where you could be doing better. What could you be doing less of? What could you be doing more of? Is there a different habit that you can swap out for a bad habit? And by the way, hello, I am Christina. I am a certified behavior change specialist, a manifestation expert, and an EFT practitioner. I created this channel to help people improve their lives and improve their mind, their body, and their soul. So if topics like this video or manifestation, mindset, body image, confidence, if any of that stuff interests you, please consider subscribing. And I just want to end it that if you are going through a glow up right now, or if you are wanting to glow up, I commend you, because change is not easy. It's not easy for us, and it's not easy for the people around us. But you are totally worth it. As cliche as that is, you get this one life and this one chance, and you are not getting any younger. So now is the perfect time to step into your power, stop settling, and show up a little shinier. Find your tribe and surround yourself with really positive people who are supportive and uplifting and want to see you become your best. But also be ready for your friends or maybe acquaintances or maybe some of your family members to go in and poke and remind you of who you used to be and what you used to do and how you used to live. And that's okay. Just stay centered and stay confident and know that you're heading in the right direction, and eventually with time, they will get over it and they will get used to this new version of you. This is also a great time to just prioritize your mental health and your self-care. Find some things that bring you joy, bring you happiness, make you feel fulfilled and connected. It can be anything. It can be anything outside of your community. It can be, for me, it's like going to the gym, painting my nails, doing my makeup, changing my room around, coloring, just being with my family, rollerblading, reading a book sometimes. It doesn't have to be, you know, all this luxurious, extravagant self-care type of stuff, but it's literally anything that makes you feel pretty and makes you feel happy. That is my definition of self-care. And stay true to your goals, stay true to your mission, stay true to your vision. Get centered with, who do you want to be? How do you want to feel? What do I want out of my life? Who do I want in my life? And just stay on that path and take that aligned action every day to make sure that you are getting closer and closer to having and becoming those things. So at the end of the day, the last thing that I would want you to do is to glow up and improve yourself, but be really uncomfortable with other people's opinions and judgments to the point to where you kind of go back to your old self that wasn't happy and wasn't feeling fulfilled, just because that might feel a little bit more comfortable. Your glow up will inspire others. It will inspire the right people. So share your story and go out there and do whatever you can to be happier, healthier, and more confident. And just know that I am always in your corner.